often ask me why I stay at convents instead of hotels. Well, why not? The convents that I stay at are set up to offer hospitality not just to religious pilgrims, but to tourists like me as well. Typically, the rooms are very clean, small, and simple, and most have their own private bathrooms. Also very small, with an open shower that's part of the bathroom itself. Or is the bathroom part of the shower? Either way, the only thing that separated the shower from the toilet was the shower curtain. But each bathroom has its own obligatory bidet. Many convents have communal bathrooms as well as private ones, and room prices are lower if you opt for a room with a communal bathroom. But don't worry, the bathrooms are always very clean. Usually, you're reminded that you're in a convent because, for the most part, they follow the rules of simplicity. But that's not true for all convents. The convent of Saint Elisabetta in Florence is quite ornate, and the rooms have shimmery, moiré wallpaper, beautiful wooden wardrobes, and large modern bathrooms. But one thing most convents I've stayed at had in common were large windows with breathtaking views. Aside from feeling safe, surrounded by nuns or monks if you're staying at monasteries, you don't have to worry about your room not being squeaky clean. Larger convents that are run only by a few nuns employ a housekeeping staff. But nuns in smaller convents do their own housekeeping. And you know, cleanliness is next to godliness. In some convents, you can opt for a continental breakfast in the refectory that's prepared by the nuns themselves. And in convents such as Suore del Giglio, for a reasonable price, the nuns also prepare delicious homemade dinners from scratch for their guests. I've seen their kitchen and it rivals those of most restaurants. You just have to sign up in the morning so they prepare enough for everyone. There's no menu, you just sit and you're served. I haven't heard any complaints from anyone that they didn't absolutely love what they were served. But all in all, it's like being at home eating grandma's home-cooked meal. And many of the nuns at the convent indeed look like kind little grannies. Nuns who run hospitality convents have a primary duty to run it like a hotel, including all of the office duties. Some are really adept at using a computer and maintaining their own websites and answering emails. They do the shopping, carry cell phones, and watch TV when their daily duties are over. And they drive all over the place. You should see them maneuver around those narrow little slope streets like Hollywood stunt drivers in a stick shift car. You do not want to mess with those nuns behind the wheel because they mean business when they're on the road. I was very impressed when one of the nuns offered to drive me to the train station one day. They're not technologically inept, these nuns. And unlike the stereotype of those mean Catholic school nuns, many of the nuns I've met are actually cool, especially the younger ones. If you weren't for their frocks, you'd forget you're talking to a nun. Next thing you know, you start telling them about the cute guy at a coffee shop you met, and it doesn't even dawn on you that although they're politely smiling, they're really not as enthusiastic about your newfound hottie as you are. But they also have a great sense of humor, even the monks. one particular Franciscan monk in Assisi, Brother John, was a professional and engaged to be married when he decided instead to pursue theology. So it seems that in Italy, all the good ones are either married or joined the seminary. But when I asked him about giving up, you know, it was kind of hard to put into words, he just laughed and said, well, who wants to put up with one woman for the rest of his life anyway? Well, I don't think he get much argument from most guys out there. One other elderly nun, however, when I asked her the same question about men, and yes, I really did push the envelope that time with my questions, but I had to know. She said, well, just because you can't order, it doesn't mean you can't look at the menu. So they didn't leave their sense of humor behind when they embraced a life in a convent or monastery. Aside from the high-tech